sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Uptown Charlotte at rain-soaked Bank of America Stadium. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Atlanta Falcons and the Carolina Panthers.
To kick off.
A pair of 3-0 teams set to lock horns for the right to remain unbeaten. And we're off in week four. Fielded near the back of the end zone. Christian McCaffrey, and he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight at the 27-yard line.
Set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. 12 yards there and a first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
For the most part, that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. On first down, Craig. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
On second down now, it's Craig. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Check, crunch, crunch, crunch. Check 52.
And they're going option play on third down. And they'll rally and stop him short of the first down at about the six. It's a six-yard gain, and it leaves him looking at a fourth down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
A 23-yard attempt.
And his kick here is good. Well, after marching down the field, only getting three there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
And 10 at the 25-yard line.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. From the gun, it's Haskins. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. Remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
Come up to the line now, facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. Out of the shotgun, Haskins. Oh, and it's intercepted. He was trying to get it to Ridley. Dante Jackson picks it, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
And Brandon, the passing game for both of these teams is going to be affected as the game goes along. It's not looking like the rain's going to let up anytime soon, so that might mean a few more wobbly passes and wide receiver slips, and this one winds up getting intercepted.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead. Solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it first and 10. And he's going to lose yardage here, back to his own 18. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll make this a second and 13. Haskins. They'll run the screen with Carson. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14.
And it's third down.
Completion actually lost a yard, so now they'll need to convert on third down. Here's Haskins out of the gun, looking deep downfield. He rifles one that's intercepted. Monte Nicholson picks it. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. This is McCaffrey. The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. And the Falcons grab it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And hopefully for both sides, not a sign of things to come, Charles. This morning, it was so perfect outside, but we knew this weather was coming, and we see the effects of it here early on.
And I wonder if how perfect it was this morning has psychologically fooled everyone. You know, it's almost like even though we were told the weather was coming, and you know the teams knew it as well, then maybe they got fooled and thought, it's going to be okay. And now they're probably a little upset that it's out there.
Because warm-ups were dry.
Oh, we're dry. Now you've got to make the change up, and it's the first quarter. Might take them a little time to settle in on their focus and concentration.
On second down, Dotson. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
Right back to him on first down. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. The defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
A very quick pass to Ridley. Complete. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
7 yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
10-0 the score after one on EA Sports.
10. Falcons nothing.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. They run the counter. Carson, no gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
No gain on the play.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line.
At their own 33-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, the fumble, the turnover. Now, they still have the lead, but I don't think coaches care. The turnovers will bother them no matter what the scoreboard says.
That's the relief, that you still have the lead. But coaches look at what if and what it should be. Turning the ball over when they've got a chance to score more points and increase the lead, that's what's going to affect them.
And they're also thinking to future weeks, maybe when the game's closer, right?
No doubt about it. You want to clean up everything. Let's just be honest about it. They want everything to be perfect at all times. They don't want to give up anything that's going to hurt their team.
Check, 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 check. Shoot. Watch the shoot. He's checking, he's checking, he's checking. Crash, crash. Check, check. Mark. Check three, team. Shoot.
Here's McCaffrey. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory.
Christian McCaffrey.
Grady Jarrett with the tackle. But you talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Off the play fake. Brennan. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. Just a five-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down.
One-handed. Love the effort. Not much production on that play, though, huh?
Not a whole lot of yardage. You get that grab, you probably want a first down.
And he'll be the one in the film session and be saying, hey, run that one back, coach.
Yeah.
Run that one back.
One more time.
Let's see that
Two
again.
More time.
And they won't.
Eight more time.
They won't. Didn't get much out of it.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line.
At their own 12-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And this not an easy situation. You're down early in the elements. You're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Brings up second and 10.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Now they'll look to Haskins to throw it. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
The Falcons on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 10. Now it's Haskins. Blitz coming and down he goes.
Well, there's your first ROI, right? Return on investment of their first round pick. His first NFL sack. I know they want him to be an impact player right out of the gate.
A lot of pressure to put on a young man, but I think you agree he has the ability to deliver on it.
And he just did. Probably the first of many sacks in a long career.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. McCaffrey. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
End result of that one, a nice 4-yard gain. So you can use that to set up your play action game. or you can come right back and continue to run the football, because as an offensive play caller, you're on schedule and feeling pretty good about your next couple of calls.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. McCaffrey. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And he takes it all the way down to the 22. 23 yards the pickup there.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. 10-0 our score. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
On first down, it's Craig. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 1-yard line.
And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. Not going to get through here on try number one. They stop him at the goal line. Call it no gain, and it's going to be second and goal.
Leads to second and goal.
So they've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. Can they find the end zone here on second and goal? A carry here for the big tight end. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden, it's third and goal at the one. So it's third and goal, and now the question, can this Falcon defense stand tall once more? Here's a quick throw out left. It's complete. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Gary Jennings, his first touchdown on the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded in the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Well, look at the clock here. You're inside of a minute. The first half hasn't gone that well for you. How are you going to play this drive?
Well, I've been told by my coaches previously that the intelligent approach, go ahead and run out the clock and start over. Don't make any more mistakes. But there's also something to understanding that you've got this last drive here. You get the ball to start the second half. Try and go 2-for-1 here. Get some points now and come out of the locker room and get more points again and get your momentum really built up.
Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts.
Brings up second
as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. To throw again on second down. Haskins going for the deep ball. And yet again, Haskins is intercepted. Third time. Picked off near the 29. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. This is McCaffrey on the give, and he gets it down to the 32. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
32-yard line.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. McCaffrey on the counter. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work. But when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen.
And he loses the football a second time. And the Falcons grab it. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
Recovered by Atlanta.
Took nearly the entire first half, but a first red zone opportunity for him here. They have a first and 10 at the 18. Play of the half, it's Haskins toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. His throw's going to be incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And it's third down.
And the passing windows are just not there. And that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And that will be incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
31 yards on the punt there. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. Time to the tailback. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Another run, this time McCaffrey. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 15 yards on the play, first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Check, check, lucky, lucky, lucky.
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. A gain of 3, 2nd down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through, no place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
On 2nd down, McCaffrey. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a 1st down at the Falcons 14. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a 3rd and inches situation. Here, losing yardage back to the 16. He lost 2 and it brings up 4.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. From the right hash, this from 33. Increases to 20-0. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point's not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3 and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. Austin Hooper, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
25-yard line.
He's him back. 31 to mark.
Throwing again. Haskins. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. It's a loss of four. Now third down.
Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. And that play, it wound up losing yardage.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, Haskins. And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Looking to throw. Brennan, they'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
They'll run on first down. Craig. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
A handoff, McCaffrey running right. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
It looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal.
And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season, and the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And Charles, when you catch that toss going right or left, really, but right in this instance, do you go straight for the pylon? Is that where you're going?
Well, typically you want to try and maneuver people a little bit so you have some space to get to the pylon. So I want to make sure I try to move them a little bit to the inside, and in this case to the left, so I can get to the right side and get to that pylon and wink at it as I go by.
Falcons. Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And that stretches the lead all the way up to 27.
Takes this about 5 yards deep. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
at their own 25-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Second and six, just inside the 30. On play action, Haskins. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. And we're back now in Charlotte. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. The Falcons on for six thus far. This will be third and six. I don't think anyone in the building fooled right there, as that one is going to blow up in their faces. Disaster there, resulting in a loss of seven on third down. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll try and throw for it with Haskins. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Dante Jackson picks it. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. But just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception. And this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
Yeah, a lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. And I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning. Trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off a game.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more. And again, this time to the tailback. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed three, he got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. A field goal team for the third time today. From the left hash mark, this a 43-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it? And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Troy Pride. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Pass
The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, it certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. Stops shy of the 45 despite some powerful running. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Christian McCaffrey with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And this offense is running away with this one. They seemingly just continue to score at will. As great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
It's second and eight.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They run again with Carson. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
A third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 6 yards in the wrong direction that time. Not only that, but it brings up fourth.
It's fourth down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. Some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now a give, right side. It's Craig, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. Give him 3 yards there, as that'll take us to fourth down.
It's fourth down.
Hey. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They've got a fourth down here in a game that looks to have been decided already. So we were looking at each other up here in the booth when they went for that, saying, oh, wow, talk about trying to add insult to injury.
Some teams are just like that. You know, some philosophies, some coaches are like, look, when I got a chance to put some more points on the board, I don't care what the situation, I'm going to do it. And they're also the same coaches, as a general rule, that if someone does it to them, you won't hear a peep of protest out of them. That's just who they are.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Now Haskins to throw it. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Call it a pickup of 7, and it's a second down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw completion.
Well, it just seems like all game long there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the
And my goodness, another interception. Jeremy Chinn picks it off. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 43-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game, and that's always puzzled me a little bit.
Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number 2. And they take a knee. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Remember, they have won 3 straight, but getting to 4 straight does not appear to be in the cards, as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
First down, Atlanta.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Haskins. He's going to let it fly. And now here is another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it. And he will be out of bounds here with zeros on the clock as this ball game is over.
Today's final score, Panthers 37.